taught you about introduction of resources, characteristics of resources and classification of resources, in which I taught you first classification of resources, that is on the basis of origin. Today I am going to teach you about the next classification of resources, that is on the basis of exhaustibility. On the basis of exhaustibility, we can classify resources into two parts. First is renewable resources and another one is non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are the resources which are renewed and reproduced again and again. For example, water, forest, solar and wind energy. Next is non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources are the resources which take millions of years in their formation. For example, coal, petrol and fossil fuel. In short, we can say that renewable resources are the resources which we can use again and again. And non-renewable resources are just opposite to renewable resources, which have fixed amount. And we should use these resources economically and wisely. Let us understand this topic with video.
Water is most important natural resource. Every living thing needs water in order to survive. Water is considered renewable resources because it moves through the water cycle, but we still need to conserve it and keep rivers, lakes and other water supply clean. Trees can be cut down, but it can be planted again. Scientists also considered sunlight, winds, plants and animals as renewable resources.
Non-renewable resources are those that cannot be renewed or regenerated after they are used up completely. Thus, they have to be used economically and wisely. Examples include coal, fossil fuels, petroleum and crude oil.
Resources into four categories. First is individual resources, second is community resources, third is national resources, and last is international resources. Let's talk about individual resources. Individual resources are the resources owned privately by an individual. For example, land, house, car, etc. In short, we can say that individual resources are the resources in which the only one person society. For example, you are living in a society and there is a swimming pool. That swimming pool belongs to your family also and other family also, those who are living nearby. Next we have national resources. Technically all the resources belong to the nation. So the resources belong to the nation is called national resources. Means every citizens of the country use that resources. Next we have international resources. International resources are the resources in which all the countries of the world use the resources. Let us understand this topic with more examples.
Individual resources. These are the resources privately owned by the individual or groups. Example, land owned by individual, a family or group of people organized in companies. Community. Many Adivasis do not believe in private ownership of land, forest and water bodies. They consider these resources as owned by the community. For example, public lands, roads, well, parks and panchayatkar in urban and rural areas. National resources. These resources are owned by the government. In the past, All land, water and other natural resources were considered to be owned by the king, emperor or the ruler. Even today, the government owns such resources of general public use as railway, irrigation, canal, roads, building, etc. International resources. These resources are owned by the international institutions like the United Nations or other regional international organizations.
Let's talk about last classification of resources, that is on the basis of status of the development. On the basis of the status of development, we can classify resources into four categories. First is potential resources, second is development resources, third is stock, and last is reserves. So let's talk about potential resources. Potential resources are the resources which are found in a region but have not been utilized. For example, solar and wind energy in Rajasthan and Gujarat. In short, we can say that you have a resources, you have a technology, but you have not developed them. Next, we have developed resources. Developed resources are the resources which are surveyed and their quality and their quantity have been determined for its utilization. For example, you have resources, you also have technology, you also know about their quality and quantity, and you have been using them. Next, we have stock. The resources which are obtained in the environment and have potential to satisfy human needs, but human beings do not have proper technology to use them properly. Means you have resources available in your stock, but the only problem is that you do not have technology to use that resources properly. Next, we have reserves. The resources are available to you but have not yet been used properly. Let us understand this topic with more examples.
Potential resources. These resources are found in a certain regions but may not have been utilized. For example, Rajasthan and Gujarat have enormous potential for the development of wind and solar energy, but these have not been utilized so far. Developed. These resources have been surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization. It now depends on the available technology and its feasibility to utilize these resources. Stock. The resources are obtained from an environment. They may have limited stock available for use. It may also be possible that we may not have appropriate technology to mine these resources. Therefore, these resources are included in the stock. For example, water is a rich resource of an energy. Reserves. These resources are in stock and can be put into many uses with the help of technology.
Next topic we have sustainable development. Sustainable development is defined as economic development that ensures the use of resources and the environment without compromising the needs of future generations. The Earth Summit held in June 1992 at Rio de Janeiro in Brazil discussed for the first time issues concerning with our environment. The Earth Summit, attended by 100 heads of the states, and adopted Agenda 21. Agenda 21 clearly states that we should protect, we should preserve our sustainable development naturally. We should not hurt or harm the resources. We need to preserve the resources. We need to modify the resources. So along with the sustainable development, it clearly claimed that we should have our own local Agenda 21. This is all about our today's class. In next video, we will discuss about land resources, land degradation.